gloria in excelsis et Deo. Nobis sub sacramento mirabili passionis tuae memoriam reliquisti. Tribuque sumus itanos corporis et sanguinis tui sacra mysteria venerari. Ut redemptionis tuae fructum in nobis iugiter sanensianus. Qui vivis et regnias cum Deo Patri in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Legesio epistule beati Pauli apostoli ae Corinthios. Fratres, ego enim accipia Domino quod et tradidi vobis, quoniam Dominus Iesus in qua noget et tradebatum. Accepit panem et gratias agens fregit et digesit, accipite et monducate. Hoc est corpus meum quod pro vobis tradetur, hoc facite in meam commemorationem. Similiter de calicem postquam cenavit dicens, ic calix novum testamentum est in medio sanguine. Hoc facite quoties cumque bibetis in meam commemorationem. Quoties cumque enim manducabitis panem unque et calicem bibetis, mortem Domini annunciabitis dorum ec veniat. Itaque qui cumque manducaverit panem unc, vel biberi de calice domini indigne, reus erit corporis et sanguinis domini, probeter autem seive sumomo, et sig de pane illuedat et de calice viva, qui enim manducat et bibit indigne, iudicium sibi manducat et bibit, non diudicans corpus domini. Laudation Salvatore, lauda ducem de pastorem, in imenis et canticis.
Quantum potest tantum arum, quia maiorum ni laude, ne laudare sufficit.
Laudis et ema specia, novi regis, novum pasca nove legis, false vetus terminat.
Vetus datem novitas, umbram fugat veritas, noctem lux eliminat.
Quod in cena Christus gesit, facienetum hoc expressit in sui memoria.
Toti sacris institutis, panem vinum in salutis, con secramus hostiam.
Dogma datur Christianis, quod in carnem transit panis, et vinum igne sanguine.
Quod non capis, quod non vidus, animus affirmat fidus, preterum mordim.
Subet divers igis specieribus, sinis tantum et non rebus, latent res exit.
Sanguis
assurum emete non conecisus, non confragetus non divisus, in te cerara cipitu. Sumunt boni, sumunt mali, soret et amen in equali, vite vel in territus.
Mos et malis vita mons, vide paris uncius, omsit disparexitus.
Fragto demum sacramentum, ne vacilles sed mementu, tantum esse nunc sub fragmentu, quantum totur tegitu.
Nulla reifici sua, sine tantum fit factum, et nextatus nextatum, signat
ecce panis angelorum, factus et cibus viatorum, vere panis figiliorum, non miten dubus et canibus.
In figuris presignatum, omis agimolotum, agnus possede.
Bone pastor panis verere, Iesu nostri miserere, tu nos pace nos tuere, tu nos bona fac videre, in terra vivensium.
Tu qui contasces et volus, qui nos facis sic
Dominus vobiscum. Sequentia sancti Evangelii secundum Dixit Iesus turbis Iudeorum, carum ea vere est cibus, et sanguis meus vere est potus. qui manducat meam carnem et bibit meum sanguinem in me manet, et ego in illum. Sicut misit me vivens pater, et ego vivo propter paterem, et qui manducat me et ipse vivet propter me. Hic est panis qui de celo descendit. Non sicut manduca verunt patres vestri mano, et motum isus, qui manduca truc panem, vivet in aeternum.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. My dear brethren and dear friends, today is the first day of the Sacred Heart Novena. These blessed days, these holy days that are very dear to us, very dear to everybody here in Limerick, regardless our origin, our language, our heart beats for our Lord Jesus Christ. Our heart here in the city center of Limerick wants to beat at the same rhythm as our Lord's divine heart. So we are especially tonight united with all the friends of our community, all the souls who are following us and being united to us remotely through the live stream. Live stream is good, of course. We have experienced that so many times during a long, so many months last year and this year, but it's not enough. We cannot be fed, spiritually fed, without physically attending the holy sacrifice of the Mass, without sacramentally receiving the Blessed Sacrament. So today, the feast of Corpus Christi, the feast of the Blessed Sacrament, with all our hearts, with all our intentions, we would like to say, in the deepest part of our heart, a great and renewed thank God. Thank God because we can now celebrate this Sacred Heart Novena. Thank God for the holy sacrifice of the Mass. Thank God for the priesthood. Thank God for the sacrament. Thank God for this highest sacrament of the Holy Eucharist. Thank God we now all attend physically the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass and according to our vocation. You see, in the Church we are all, of course, at different places in the Church, respecting social distancing, which is so important. The priest is at the altar, facing God. The altar boys serve at the altar. All of you, as lay people, you are in the nave. All, each one of us, according to our personal vocation. And you have all noticed as well, between you and the priest, there are, this year, two of the sister adorers of the Royal Heart. They are, these sisters are the female branch of our community, the Institute of Christ the King, and we are very grateful to them for, first of all, responding to this beautiful vocation, being spouse of Christ, having a life consecrated to God, having a life consecrated to daily adoration, praying for the priest, praying for the sanctification of the priest, carrying, receiving all our prayer intentions. We thank God for them, we thank God for their community, we thank God for their community life that they follow in already 4 countries throughout the world. And our sisters are now almost 60 sisters, sister adorers of the Royal Heart. And of course, as you all know, we thank God because they pray a lot. They are great benefactors of this church. I often send them some messages, some emails to ask to pray for a special intention. And they pray a lot. They pray remotely from the novitiate in Naples, in Italy, from Livorno in Italy, from Switzerland, from Preston in England, from the States now. And of course, as you have all heard these last few weeks, we have the great blessing now that we have the certainty, the assurance that our sisters are not only going to keep praying remotely for us, but will soon be present for good in Ireland as our community has recently acquired this beautiful convent of mercy from the Mercy Sisters in Ardee, County Louth. Our sisters will soon be moving there and will be praying even closer to us, praying for Ireland, praying for the church, praying for all your families, and having, especially following their vocation with daily adoration and for the sanctification of priests. So we thank God, of course, for all these greatest blessings. And today in this Feast of Corpus Christi, we especially keep in our hearts these words from the Gospel. We thank God for the living bread that came down from heaven. We thank God to our Lord Jesus Christ, the second person of the Most Holy Trinity, God Himself, who said, "Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink." This is, dear friends, not only one verse lost in the middle of the whole Gospel. It's an invitation to all of us, an invitation, a personal invitation from our Lord, who tells us personally, "Come, come to me, come to this novena, pray, come and open your heart, come and let your heart be filled with my grace." Our Lord tells us in the sacraments, our Lord tells us in the devotions, He tells to all mankind, He invites everybody to approach Him spiritually, Mount Calvary, and to consider Him on the cross. Listen to His voice, and let us really listen to His words, "Come to me." We come to Him as we approach Him in the real presence. Our Lord Jesus Christ is really, truly, substantially present in the Holy Eucharist. This is what the Church calls the real presence. And this real presence, dear friends, dear brethren, has begun in the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary. The flesh which Jesus received from His mother is the same flesh into which He changed bread at the Last Supper. And again, the blood He received from His mother is the same blood into which He changed wine at the Last Supper. This is the great mystery of the Holy Eucharist, in which His human mind and will are united with the divinity. It's how our Lord is really present. Body, blood, soul, and divinity under the appearances of bread and wine. You know, we call the sacraments, they are not all of them, not all of them are at the same level. The number 7 has been written for good and forever and defined by the Council of Trent. But the Holy Eucharist is really called the highest sacrament. This is actually the most important sacrament. Let us really just receive it. Keep these words. The Holy Eucharist is the highest sacrament. And the Church today celebrates this highest sacrament. And really, we could even, with our unworthiness, with all our weaknesses, we could humbly ask ourselves, how do we really believe in this highest sacrament? How do we personally renew this act of faith? And how do we really want to deepen our spiritual life in this sacrament? If I ask you, I'm sure that you will all tell me, yes, of course, I agree, Canon. I do believe that our Lord is truly, really, substantially present in the Holy Eucharist. But then at the same time, tell me, would you not come to the church and would you be slightly used to seeing the red light somewhere in the church? Okay, on this part of the church, the most dignified part of the church. We know that there is a red light. We know that we have to make a genuflection to adore our Lord, present in the tabernacle. But isn't it sometimes just a habit? Think today. Does your knee touch the floor when you genuflect? If you are not sure about that, God knows. We have to think about that. Things that no one sees, God knows. God knows everything. Deus sit omnia. God knows everything. And in the same time, I'm sure you could return the question. You could tell me, by the way, Canon, when you celebrate Holy Mass every day, how do you believe in the real presence? This is all our weaknesses, our lack of faith, that we all have, according to our vocation, to renew and to confess, to affirm, to proclaim, to believe in. And the Church, the liturgy, the traditional Catholic teaching helps us. But something that helps us a lot as well is all our predecessors, the Catholic faith, all the martyrs who gave their life to defend the real presence, all those who died to confess the real presence of our Lord Jesus Christ and who did not deny him, all those who could imagine just the martyrs who did their best and who were killed just because they tried or they wanted to preserve, to rescue the Blessed Sacrament from a tabernacle, from a church being attacked, from somewhere where the real presence was, where Jesus was dwelling in the tabernacle. Something that certainly helps us a lot is the existence of Eucharistic miracles. I know that there are a lot, and some are very impressive. We might certainly think about one of the most important ones, the miracle of Lanciano. But then if you even ask to some of our altar boys, they will tell you, we went to Siena in Italy, next to the seminary, and then our good Canon Leboc took us to Siena, and we prayed at the main church where the miracle took place, where all these hosts that were stolen were hidden in a box, were then miraculously preserved, and are now again adored every day. But have you heard no longer, not only about Siena, but a bit down in the south, on the way to Rome, there is a beautiful city called Orvieto. And there is not only the famous St. Patrick's Well, Il Pozzo di San Patrizio, but also a great miracle took place next to this city in Orvieto, which is called Bolsena. There, my dear friends, in 1263, a priest was on his way to Rome. He had to celebrate his private mass, and unfortunately, he had some doubts against the real presence. Unfortunately, he was certainly celebrating Holy Mass by habit and with not enough attention, not enough preparation. And what happened during Holy Mass, even if he was described as being pious, he had these struggles in his faith, and he was not believing enough in the real presence. And while celebrating Holy Mass, he had barely pronounced the words of the consecration when the blood started to seep from the consecrated host and trickle over his hands unto the altar and the corporal. The corporal is this square linen that is between the altar cloth and the chalice to preserve, just in case, if ever a drop of the most precious blood or little particles, the real presence, to prevent them from falling on the altar or being, let us say, falling into the altar cloth. The priest there in 1263 was confused, and he first attempted to hide the blood, and then he interrupted the mass and asked to be taken to the neighboring city of Orvieto. And then he had this famous meeting with Pope Urban IV, who was residing there. And this linen corporal, this miraculous linen, has been preserved. When I was a young priest, that's a long time ago, I was in Italy, you know, after my ordination, thank God for that. And with our community, we were going to Rome for a pilgrimage as well. And one of the important, very beautiful parts of my priestly life was this time when in Orvieto, we all had a little break with the community, with all the seminarians. And we went to this chapel, and we prayed in the presence of this miraculous corporal, this miraculous linen that still contains the stains of the most precious blood. With the community, we sang the sequence Lauda Sion that was sung during Holy Mass today, which was, as you know, composed by St. Thomas Aquinas. So, dear friends, let us always remember throughout our life how every Mass is a miracle, how each time we come to a church where the real presence is, we are in the presence of our Lord. Each time a priest consecrates the bread and wine to Christ's actual body and blood, it's a real miracle that occurs. A miracle which is twofold, as we know. The bread and wine are changed into the body, the blood, the soul, and the divinity of Jesus, but in the same time, the appearance of bread and wine remain. And this is what makes a miracle each time a Mass is celebrated. Let us, my dear friends, always remember this important part of our faith. Where the Holy Eucharist is celebrated, Jesus is present in the consecrated host and wine with his body, his blood, his soul, and his divinity. This is the grace we should really ask to our Lord Jesus Christ on this first day of the Sacred Heart Novena. Let us, on a very special way today, renew our desire to adore him more sincerely, him, our Lord, present in the Blessed Sacraments with his divine heart. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. At the end of Mass, we will have the Corpus Christi procession that will take place here in the church. Please remain at your seats. I will be carrying the Blessed Sacrament throughout the church, but I kindly ask you to remain in your seat. Thank you very much. God bless you again.
credo in unum et Deum.
Deum.
omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum. Sum corda. Gratia sagamus Domino Deo nostro. Vere dignum et justum est, ecum et salutare. Nos tibi serem per et ubique, gratia sagere. Domine sancte pater omnipotens eterne Deus, quia per incarnati verbi mysterium, nova mentis nostri oculix lux tuo ecla, rita tigis in fulsit. Ut dum visibiliter degum coronio roscimus, perunc in invisibilium amorem rapiamur. Et cum angelis et arcangelis, cum tronis et dominationibus, cum quae omni militia celestis exercitus, hymnum gloriae tuae caranimus, sine fine di.
Romania secula seculorum. Recepti salutaribus monitim, et divina in institutione formati, auderemus dicere. Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in celo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis odie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimitimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentatione. Per Romania secula seculorum. Pax Domini sit semper vobis.
Thank you. Miseria tu vestri omnipotens Deus, dimissis peccatis vestris, paducat vos et vitam aeternam. Indulgentiam absolutionem et remissionem peccatorum vestrorum, ebo ad vobis omnipotens et misericordionis. Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccata mundi, Domine non sum dignus, qui praes pecte meum, et tantum dic verbo et senagitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus, qui praes pecte meum, et tantum dic verbo et senagitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus, qui praes pecte meum, et tantum dic verbo et senagitur anima mea.
Dominus vobis.
Oremus, fare nos quae sumus domine divinitatis tui sempiterna fruitionere pleri, quam pretiosi corporis et sanguinis tui temporalis percepsio prefigurat, qui vivis et regnas cum Deo Patri in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Dominus vobis. Ite.
Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus,
Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
Thank you. Deus omnium fidelium, pastorate regitore, fabulum tuum Franciscum, quem pastorem ecclesiae tue prese voluisti propitius a respice. Dai quesus verbo et exemplo quibus prees profice. Ut ad vita una congrege sibi credito per venia de sanctiter. Per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Deus qui nobis suae sacramento mirabili passionis tuae memoriam reliquisti, tribu equesum usit annos corporis et sanguinis tui sacra mysteria venerari, ut redemptionis tuae fructum in nobis iugit essentiamus, qui vivis et regnas in saecula saeculorum.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be
His holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, the true God and true man.
Blessed
be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be his
most sacred heart.
Blessed
be his most precious blood.
Blessed
be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed
be the Holy Ghost, the Paraclete.
Blessed
be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy.
Blessed
be your holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed
be her glorious Assumption.
Blessed
be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed
be St. Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed
be God in his angels and in his saints.
Blessed be God in his saints.